Computers for the Blind refurbishes no longer needed computers, and then we install the assistive technology on them that make them accessible to persons who are blind. Our volunteers do all of this work, and then we ship them out, Free Matter for the Blind, throughout the country. We have 5 shifts of volunteers, Monday through Thursday afternoons, and then on Saturday morning. And so all total, we probably have about 40 or 50 volunteers. Some do it twice a week, and some once a week, and then some a couple times a month. Mm-hmm. We have a refurbishing center with several workstations and servers and everything we need to refurbish the computers. We have a drill press that any computer that we're not able to use, we can destroy the hard drive. We have the software that is certified by the Department of Defense that kills all the information on the hard drives, and then we re-image the computer. And then we have a blower machine that blows out all the dust bunnies and everything. So, yeah, we've got everything we need. We have an individual who's blind that is out of state that provides tech support to help people with problems when they're using their computer. Some of the software we have is licensed software, and so they can also get support from the software manufacturer. Yeah, tomorrow's a very exciting day. The agency's been around for over 25 years, but the growth of the organization has been dramatic in the last 4 years. About 4 years ago, we provided our 6,000th computer. Then a year ago, we did our 9,000th computer, and tomorrow we'll be presenting our 10,000th computer to a person that lives in Plano, which is just north of Richardson. And so it's going to be an exciting event. We've got some folks from the Richardson Mayor's office, some city councilmen, the organization that provides a lot of our grants. It's called the Reading and Radio Resource Fund. They will be there, as well as many of the volunteers and our staff and folks from the community. We get a lot of support from the local Lions clubs, and some of them will be there as well. They sell very inexpensively. We sell a desktop for $110 and a laptop for $130, but somebody that can't afford them, who's on SSI or SSDI, can get them for half that amount, including parents of blind children, regardless of their income. It's difficult for parents to buy computers for their children, and we feel like it's essential for a blind student to be able to compete with his sighted peers. So we're trying to get more computers into the hands of youth who are blind. Attended a conference a little while back, and they did some research that showed that 99% of sighted high school students use their computers to do internet searches, to do their homework, to do their senior papers, and so forth, whereas blind students, only 63% have internet access. And I was thinking, well, how can that be? Because of the public education laws, require the schools to be accessible. Well, they have access to a computer at school that's accessible, but they go home, they don't have one at home to do their homework or other things that the sighted students do, and therefore the graduation rate for blind people is low. The entrance into college is much lower than the sighted population, as well as college graduation rates. So we're trying to change that a little bit. We used to get enough, but lately we have not been able to keep up. Recently had to purchase a couple of hundred laptops, a couple of hundred computers and monitors, because we just essentially ran out of our inventory. So we are reaching out to the business community as well as individuals to try and get donations of computers. We have, I have a cargo van that somebody donated to us, and so I go around the DFW area and pick up the larger donations from employers. But if individuals in the Dallas-Fort Worth area want to donate a computer, we have several drop-off locations that are listed on our website where they can go and drop off the computer at one of our community partners, and then when they have a load, I'll just swing by and pick them up. We have a lot of folks that have computers that are sitting in their closets or in their garages because they don't know what to do with them. They're concerned about their confidential information being exposed, or they don't know, you know, even if they pull the hard drives out, they don't know how to get rid of the computers. They're hard to get rid of. So we're happy to take them off their hands. We'll pick them up for free if it's, you know, more than five or six computers. If not, they can drop it off in their local community at one of our drop-off locations. We'd be happy to set them up with public library. We have, for example, there's some Centers for Independent Living that are drop-off locations, the Dallas Lighthouse for the Blind, the Fort Worth Lighthouse for the Blind, American Foundation for the Blind has an office in Dallas. We have a community theater in Hearst and a couple of other remote locations. In fact, I think we're going to set up a restaurant in Garland. They're going to offer their customers, you know, free dessert or free appetizer if they bring in a computer.